Hey, mate. I'm Alex.
And I'm Gaston.
Welcome to Power Mate.
This is the place to learn and share about Fabric and Power Platform. If this is your first time here, don't forget to subscribe, like, and share this channel with your friends and colleagues.
Well, Power Mate, welcome back. In today's video, we are diving into an interesting topic that is Microsoft Fabric's capacities, pricing, and SKUs. Stick around as we walk through the process to understand Fabric's pricing for your organization step by step. So let's get started, Stone.
Yeah, right on. So this could be a tricky topic. Let's try to demystify the whole around, you know, SKUs and capacity models for Fabric. So let's start sharing my screen to talk about all the capacity options, why to choose one versus the other. Also, you can notice, and we are going to be going deep on this topic, but you can start balancing on what you already have. If you are already in Power BI Premium, P1, P2, or P3 nodes capacities, you can compare that with Fabric capacities. So in my screen, first of all, in this article, you can check on what are the options around, buying a Fabric subscriptions. You can see that there's two main options. One is, as we discussed in our video last week, that is, you can go to your Azure portal, you can create a new instance for Fabric, and then you can pay as you go. You know, you can pay as you go, meaning that you're going to be creating different instances for Fabric. As much as you are going to be using that Fabric capacity, that is the cost that you're getting into your Azure portal. The other option is still having Fabric capacities by the Microsoft 365 licensing model, built monthly or yearly with some kind of a monthly commitment. So that is another option. And a little bit on this one, that you can always, in the Azure SKUs, after you enable Fabric, you create your own instance. Anytime, based on your workloads, you can scale up, scale down that capacity as much as you need. As well, let's say that you are landing data using Data Factory workload in Fabric, you can pause, resume, you can automate that process eventually using the REST API on Fabric, and you can start monitoring all the cost management as you're doing right now with Azure, monitoring metrics and getting the Microsoft cost management directly from the Azure portal. So that is a real option that you can get from Fabric capacities.
Okay, and I'm talking about capacities. Someone could think about enable multiple capacities in the same tenant. That makes sense.
Yeah, that is a really interesting question, Alex. And actually, yes, you know, and the yes is, you know, based on your governance model, perhaps, the workloads that you have, the different teams working together. So just to give you an example, let's say that you are a Fabric admin and you want to enable Fabric for a new project in your organization. And you know that in that project, you're going to be leveraging, you know, landing zones using Data Factory and then creating Lakehouse or maybe Data Warehouse. And then you have another team of data scientists where you are going to be serving data and they're going to be start leveraging models and experiments and then pushing data to Power BI to create new reports in Power BI. So if you want to isolate each of those teams, meaning to have their own CPU, their own nodes, and, you know, not having any kind of constraints between how much those teams are leveraging or using your Fabric capacity and don't hit any kind of bottleneck, you can do that. You can actually create your Fabric instance, maybe one for the data engineer team, another Fabric instance for the data scientist team, and then you can assign in different workspace each of those capacities and leverage those capacities for different teams. That is just one example.
Oh, that's great. And you mentioned governance. And when you say governance, I'm start thinking on the Power BI admin. So what is going to be the main role of the Power BI admin switching to Fabric capacities?
That's an interesting question. And, you know, the way I'm trying to explain how the role of a Power BI admin is going to be switching a little bit into a Fabric admin is to understand exactly what I explained before in terms of, you know, now they're dealing only with Power BI developers or Power BI engineers. Now with Fabric, there's a whole new world open in Fabric, meaning that they're going to be talking with data engineers. They are going to be talking with data scientists. They are going to be talking with more real-time engineers that wants to land the data into custom databases. So meaning that there's much more coordination between teams. We should be aware of that. And the Fabric admin should be aware of how they're going to be managing all the resources. Of course, there's a whole Fabric metrics coming into place to understand how your organization is been leveraging and how every single team is been leveraging those different artifacts within Fabric.
Okay, that totally makes sense to me. And talking about data engineers and data scientists, is what is going to be the experience for the data engineer versus data scientist working with the different capacities?
That is the great insight. You know, I feel that, you know, at this point, first of all, you need to understand that sometimes an end-to-end solution requires multiple teams working together. But for them, having different capacities, if you are assigning, let's say, a data engineer team with one capacity, a data scientist team on another workspace with another capacity, this is going to be totally transparent for them because they're going to be just using artifacts within the workspace itself. They're not going to know if they are using or switching by one capacity or the other. And the Fabric architect at that point, they need to just understand that the end-to-end solution is one single framework besides how many capacities you're leveraging for your solution.
Okay. That's good. Okay, last but not least, for me, like a big topic, what about the cost?
Yeah, that's a big topic. And I know that everyone is discussing about this. Remember that now we are in the Fabric public preview. So meaning that everyone can go and open a trial version of Microsoft 365 E5 license. You can start playing around. You can enable a Fabric trial. Open totally free for now, but then let's switch to my screen and talk a little bit of all the SKU available and what are the capacity units for each of them and what is going to be the cost for Fabric. So as you can see, and as I mentioned before, if you want to compare your Power BI Premium with Fabric capacity, just to have a quick example on this one, this F64 Fabric capacity instance is exactly the same as the Power BI Premium P1. So you can compare all the nodes, all the vCores, all the capacity units that you already have in Power BI Premium with these Fabric capacities, meaning that you can, if you need exactly the same resources as a Power BI Premium P1 node, you can create in your Azure portal this instance. As you can see, you can scale up, you can scale down based on your needs. And that's going to be a good comparison between what you already have right now in Power BI Premium and knowing that you can anytime scale up or down your capacity based on your needs.
That's great. We're still, you know, trying to learn about the pricing and the whole things. Well, PowerMate, that wraps up today's episode. we hope you are as excited as we are about the potential of Microsoft Fabric and, of course, Microsoft Power Platform.
Yeah, stay tuned. In our next episode, we will be moving forward with the topic on Fabric One Leg.
Don't forget to subscribe to our channel, hit that notification bell, and join us on this journey.
Together, let's unlock the full potential on Power Platform and Microsoft Fabric.
Yeah.
See ya.